towards the heavens or higher than the earth.
Session has started. To ask your question, please press star 6.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory be unto God in this place, in the majestic name of Jesus. We just bless the name of the true living God in this place, the one and only true living God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory be unto God. Hallelujah. We just thank him. We lift him up. We praise his name. We magnify him because he alone is worthy to be praised, worthy of our worship, worthy to be lifted up around the world, throughout the nations. Hallelujah. Glory, God. We just bless your name in this place, Almighty King, Holy One of Israel, because there is none like you in this place. In the majestic name of Jesus, you are holy, you are righteous, you are amazing, you are magnificent. You are the one and only true living God. Outside of you, there is no other. In the name of Jesus, my God, my God, my God. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, in this place. My God, my God, my God. We want to welcome each and every last one of you to the Kingdom International Intercession and Word of Empowerment. Amen. Broadcast. I am your host, Apostle Derashay Zorn, with Divine Order Restoration Ministries International, where we are restoring the order of God, one life, one body, one nation at a time. And it is such an honor and a privilege, amen, to be in the church with you on tonight. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory be unto God. We hope and we pray, amen, that it is an honor unto you as well to meet us right here in the church. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory, 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 glory be unto God. You know, in the church, right? In the church, we're in the church, and we are shining the light of God's word on the good, the bad, and the ugly, exposing it all. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory be unto God. My God, my God. God is just so absolutely amazing, so true, so powerful. He is just a glorious King. He is just so faithful. Oh, my God, people. Oh, my Lord, my Lord, my Lord. I'm excited about what God is getting ready to release in the church on tonight, what he's doing in the life of his people. Amen. Glory to God, the love of God, the love, the depth that God has toward us, people of God. It's just absolutely amazing. And so I'm excited to be in the church with you on tonight in the presence of the one and only true living God. My God, my God, my God, my God. Again, welcome, welcome, welcome to the In the Church TV and radio broadcast. I am your host, Apostle Derashay Zorn, with Divine Order Restoration Ministries International, where we are restoring the order of God, one life, one body, one nation at a time. And we thank you. We thank you for joining us in the church on tonight. And we're getting ready to have a high, a mighty time, a glorious time in the presence of the Lord. You know how it is. You know what we do in the church, right? We shine the light of God's word in the church, right? In our hearts and in our minds. And amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. In our physical locations, our destinations, our regions, and all those things alike. Amen. Glory to God. And we spread the light, or we shine the light of God's word in these places in our lives, so that we can examine what the truth of God's word says, so that it may expose the good, the bad, and the ugly, so that we may know the truth, and the truth shall set us free. Amen. That we may walk in the fullness thereof. Amen. In the word of God, that we will not be intimidated, bamboozled, or any of those things. Amen. In the name of Jesus, you know, glory, glory, glory be unto God. You know, for such a time as this, amen, dynamic people of God. I mean, the time, amen, is now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God that the time is now. Amen. Right here in this very hour. Amen. For God's people to walk and move and my God, and live in the manifestation of God's word for our very lives. And I'm telling you, we got an awesome, amazing, phenomenal show in store for us tonight, and I'm absolutely excited about it. You know, we're going to deal, as we always, we engage in powerful conversation dealing with real issues that is taking place around the world, throughout the nations, in the lives of God's people. And so we're going to deal with, amen, tonight. Tonight's topic is that your labor shall not be in vain. I'm excited because, you know, this month, at the beginning of the month, every first Monday of September, Labor Day is celebrated in the U.S. It is celebrated in the U.S. It's also celebrated in Canada, and it is just a great celebration for the hard work, that individuals have labored to strengthen, to prosper. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. You know, a nation, right? Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And so we're going to talk about your labor will not be in vain on today, because we've been laboring. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And amen. And because of the labor that we have done, that we've been doing in the work, in the calling, in the very purpose that God has called forth in our life. Amen. Glory to God, that has strengthened and have brought forth prosperity, or bringing forth prosperity in our lives, and as well as a well-being within that in which God has called forth in our lives. And so we want to just talk about just some different things, and I want to encourage somebody tonight about your labor not being in vain and what thus says the Lord about it, because I know that there are many people, even in such a time as this, that's in a space in your life where, amen, glory to God, you are in a place where you've been having contractions. Some people just been having breath skin hits, and they about to lose it right there in the midst of that. Amen. Glory to God. And some people are in labor, and the baby just not turned right. It's breached, and you know, and all these other things. And we're gonna get that baby in the right position. We're gonna encourage you on tonight, and we're gonna just talk about some things. I want to help somebody come from a place of a slumber. We want to help somebody come from a sedated place. Want to help somebody on tonight to come from a place where they will not lose their baby. Their baby will not, that they will not die, amen, in the middle of childbirth, where they won't die spiritually or physically, amen, in the name of Jesus, where you would not give birth, amen, where, glory to God, I thank you, Jesus, to a baby that is breached, or a baby that is stillborn, oh my God, in the name of Jesus. So we're just going to encourage, amen, because we know that the time is now. The time is now for you to give birth to the very thing that God has called forth in your life. And so many people, amen, are going through so many different things. It is not the time, people, to stop pushing. Amen. Glory to God. It is not the time to stop pushing. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. The reason why you are, it seems like you're getting hit back to back. You are going in this intense labor. Glory to God. And you don't need to push. We don't want you to die in the midst of it. Or we don't want you to stop. Amen. And cause the baby to lose life and to lose momentum of coming forth in this manifestation because of all of the turmoil, the storms, the trials, the tribulation. So this is what I want you to do, because I'm telling you, as you can tell, that I am absolutely excited. I'm hyped. I'm ready to really go in and talk about what thus says the Lord. I'm dealing with this matter. I'm ready to help somebody on tonight to even give birth. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You got the midwife tonight. You got the midwife. Amen. On hand tonight. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus, to help you through, to help you get through these contractions. Hallelujah. I know that they're hard. Amen. my God, my God, but we're not going to give up. We're not going to, oh my God, get lazy in the middle of the birth, and we're not going to get tired in the middle of the birthing process. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. We're not going to go into a comatose state either. We're not going to be sedated through this thing. We're going to give natural birth, amen. We're going to walk this thing out boldly in the majestic name of Jesus, because we're more than a conqueror. We're not going to allow the enemy to steal our life or to steal the life of our baby right in the middle, right in the middle, right in the middle of labor, man. Ah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. I'm excited, amen, about this thing on tonight, amen. Glory to God. So I want you to do me a favor. Go ahead and share this broadcast. Go ahead and share it. I'm telling you, you're going to give those who you know, you're going to give them a great, you're going to do them a great favor. You're going to do them a great injustice on tonight as you, my God, give them this broadcast information. Amen. So go ahead and share this broadcast on your social media platforms so that those that you know can get in, they need to get in the labor room. Amen. For those that are watching us on YouTube, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. You can see I'm in the labor room. You know what? I should have put on my scrubs and everything, but that's okay. You know, amen. Glory to God that the anointing, amen, of the Holy Ghost is upon me. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So I ain't have to even get into the doctor uniform, but you can see, amen, we're in the labor room. We're in the labor room on tonight. I'm excited because I know, amen, we're about to give birth to some great things. You know, those goals, those visions, those desires, things that you've been working hard for. You've been in the trenches. You've been laboring. You've been suffering. You've been toiling, my God. And now, it's time. To push. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And give birth. Give birth so that you can see the manifestation of the word of God, amen, for your very life. Glory to God. You know somebody with a dream, with a purpose, with a vision, and glory to God, and they just been through turmoil. They've been going through one thing and the next, after the next, after the next. Amen, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And they just don't know, amen, if their dream is going to live, or if it's going to die. They're split between two decisions because what they're seeing, what they're going through, amen, it's just a difficult process to even breathe. Some people, I hear your spirit of the true living God. Some people even have time breathing, feel like you're suffocating in labor. But my God, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, we speak, amen, glory to God, even as God breathed on you right now. Right now in that place, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, that your capacity to breathe again, amen, regularly, amen, that capacity, amen, is just being filled in the name of Jesus, that you're no longer suffocating in the realm of the spirit, amen, glory to God. We know nobody knows the pain, the depth of the pain, the hurt, the injury, the pain that you're going through, or the pain that you're enduring, my God. Oh, Lord, I hear you in this place. Amen, glory to God. We're going to have to get in prayer and get started. Amen, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Because I'm telling you, y'all need to get the people on the broadcast tonight. The glory of the Lord is here. Healing is here. Deliverance is here. The power of the Lord is here. Amen. Glory to God. What you need is here. And get them here. You can send them to www.inthechurch.com. You can have them to call in on the line at 563-999-1824. They can also call in at 563-999-1824. They can go onto our social media platform on Facebook. They can get us there at In the Church. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. We just bless the name of the true living God in this place. It should be on Twitter as well, at In the Church Live. I'll check those on break to make sure, people of God. But we got to get the people, amen, get them on the Spreaker platform, whatever platform that you're on, amen, glory to God. We are accessible by 30 different platforms, avenues, even if you have the app, amen. Send them the link to the app. our radio station app so that they can download it. Glory to God, they can go to KingdomInfluencersBroadcast.com and download the app from there. Amen. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. You want to get those who you know on this broadcast tonight. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Let us go to the throne of grace, people of God. Oh, Lord, thank you. Oh, God, I bless your name. Oh, God, I magnify your name. Lord, I lift you up on high. Lord, because you are the King of glory, God, there is no one like you, God. And we're believing you in this place, and we're trusting you in this place, oh, God. And we're trusting you with all our heart and all our mind and all our might, God, and even in all our understanding and all our strength, oh, God. We're trusting you with all our heart and not leaning on our own understanding, but acknowledging you right here in this place, Father, so that you may direct our path in the majestic name of Jesus. Father, as you come into this broadcast and have your way, as I humble myself as your servant to be used by you on tonight, so that you may release your words through my mouth, oh God, straight from the throne of grace, words of activation and penetration, oh God, that would tear down, oh God, that will shy out the demonic influence in strongholds and, oh my God, in atmospheres that have been encapsulated your people, oh God, that have been trying to suffocate them, oh God, and cause the baby to die and not live. In the majestic name of Jesus, we thank you, God, that the breath of life, oh God, is coming forth through the airways on tonight, and that your people are going to be able to breathe again, and they're going to be able, Lord God, to live again, to walk up, oh God, and they're going to get the strength, oh God, that they need to push on through, to push past the hurt, the pain, the confusion, the disappointment, to let down, oh God, in the majestic name of Jesus. They're going to be able to push through the rejection, God, the hurt, the bitterness, the anger, God. Oh God, we bless your name in this place. Oh, we thank you, God, for an open heaven so that healing can break free around the world, throughout the nations, in the majestic name of Jesus. Oh, holy God of Israel, let your power reign in this place. Magnify yourself, show yourself to be true, oh God. A miracle signs and wonders begin to be performed in the lives of your children, oh God, that somebody's going to hear you very intimately on tonight, that you're going to answer their questions, oh God, that you're going to heal their pain, oh God, that they're going to be set free in the truth of your word, Father, in the majestic name of Jesus, oh holy, oh God, oh God, oh God, holy one of Israel. Oh, God, we reverence you in this place, God. We magnify you, God, in this place, God, in the majestic name of Jesus. You are mighty, God. You are holy, God. You are magnificent, Father. God, there is no one like you, Lord, in the majestic name of Jesus. Holy, holy, holy is you, Lord. Righteous, God, is you, King. Oh, we thank you for giving the breath of life again. Oh, my God, resuscitating somebody tonight, reviving somebody tonight, setting somebody free on tonight, God, in the majestic name of Jesus. Oh, powerful King, oh, mighty God, oh, righteous one, oh, my God, in the name of Jesus, oh, powerful one, omnipresent God, my God, omnipotent Father, hallelujah, bless your name in this place, omniscient and King, you are holy, my God, and now we thank you, God, that as your people open up for you on tonight, they'll open up their hearts and they'll open up their minds, oh Father, that you're setting the captives free right here in this place, in the name of Jesus, that you're releasing divine instructions and revelation from on high for your dear beloved people for such a time as this, in the majestic name of Jesus. Oh God, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you. Oh God, we bless your name, oh God, hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory to your name, oh God. We thank you that the glory, the glory, the glory, the glory, the glory, the glory. Hallelujah. Your glory is here, oh Lord, for your people in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, have your way, oh God, in the church on tonight, touching every heart and every mind and every soul that greets you in this place. We thank you for kissing them, oh God, and loving on them, oh God, and that they will feel you and that they will know you, God, in the name of Jesus. Have your way in this place. Have your way, God, in this place, in the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, and amen. To God be the absolute glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We magnify your name. Hallelujah, Lord. We glorify you in this place. It is in the name of Jesus that we have prayed. Amen, amen, and amen. My God, we are about to have a treat in the church on tonight. We about to be strengthened. We about to be empowered. Amen. Y'all go. Y'all tweet. Your labor is not in pain. I mean, your labor is not in vain. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My God, hashtag in the church. Hashtag in the church. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And go ahead and tell them to come on and get in the church on tonight at www.inthechurch.com. Or they can call in at 563-999-1824. Amen. In the name of Jesus. They can meet us on our social media platforms. They can meet us at in the church. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. They can find us at in the church on Facebook. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. They can get us right there and listen to this amazing dynamic program that God has in store for us on tonight. This broadcast, people of God, I'm telling you, is about to be explosive. It is. Amen. We are in the delivery room. Like I said, those that can see me on YouTube, amen. And if you're on the website, glory to God, I think if you just click on the option for the TV, amen, it'll take you right there, amen, on the In the Church website to watch us live there as well. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, if we have some buffer or streaming issues, amen, glory to God, you may want to just come back over to the radio platform and we'll make sure that we get the appropriate video out there later, because it's definitely coming up live as well. But hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. You guys go ahead and definitely get in the church. Get those who you know in the church on tonight with us. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. We're going to take a quick break right here in the church. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, 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 glory to God. We're going to take a break. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. Glory, glory, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Even now, people of God, as we go on this break on tonight, amen, glory to God, go ahead and get those that you know on this broadcast so that they can hear what God is saying. Amen. So they can feel the touch of the Lord on tonight, so that they may get their breakthrough, people of God. If you know somebody that need a breakthrough, you want to get them on the church. Hallelujah. You want to get them in the church on tonight. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Glory, glory, glory be unto God in this place. We'll be right back in the church in Jesus' name.
Mm-hmm. So many times I try to get on my own, but the place of my life is the truth. I give it to you. I wanna be the apple of your eye.
heart and renew in me the right spirit. I place my life at your feet. Mold me, make me after you. My desire to do what you called me to do.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. Glory be unto God in this place, in the majestic name of Jesus. Glory, glory, glory be unto God. Hallelujah, Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory be unto God in this place. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus, because guess what, y'all? He is absolutely glorious. And I love it. I love it. I just love it. Amen. In the name of Jesus, I want to welcome you back to the In the Church TV and radio broadcast, where we are shining the light on it all, the good, the bad, the ugly, exposing it all with the word of truth, so that we may know the truth and the truth may set us free. I am your host, Apostle Derashay Zorn, and it is such an honor and a privilege to be in the church with you on tonight. Amen. We do have a dynamic, a phenomenal topic that we are discussing on tonight. We're dealing with your labor. Your labor, your labor, your labor. Amen. Shall not be in vain. It shall not be in vain. So, amen. Glory to God. I do want to thank each and every last one of you who shared this broadcast on your social media platforms. We bless God for you. We thank you. It is because of the love and support of individuals like you that keep us helping, healing, keep us in a place where people are being set free. Amen. In the name of Jesus. So it's people and supporters like you that give us the opportunity to pour into thousands of lives each and every week. And so we do thank you. We thank you. We thank you for your love and for your continued support in the church on tonight. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. So, again, we're dealing with this dynamic topic. Your labor is not in vain. And so last week we left off at 1 Samuel, and we're going to go back there. I want to go back there. 1 Samuel chapter 4, I do want to go back there, people of God, and look at some things in the text. Amen. Look at some things in the text, but also be an encouragement as well to you guys in this word of truth, as well, about your labor is not in vain. Your labor is not in vain, saith the Lord. Saith the Lord. So, it shall not be in vain. There are many people that's been working hard. You've been tilling hard. You went through headaches. You've been through suffering. You've been through pain. You've been disappointed. You've been rejected. You've been let down. I mean, you've been discouraged. There's just so many things, you know, and it's sometimes, amen, and some people are in position where it's like one thing after the next, and it's like a snowball effect to just trials and tribulations and storms. And sometimes when we get in those places, sometimes we want to give up, right? We want to give up. But I'm telling you, people of God, we have worked too hard to stop in the middle of it, to give up in the middle of it. Amen. Where even in the pain, even in the hurt, even in the disappointments, even in the letdown, people of God, we got to continue to move forth in what thus says the Lord. And so we're going to just talk about some of those things on tonight. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Because I want to see your baby live and not die. I want to see the fruit, the manifestation of what it is that you've been working so hard for, what it is that you've been toiling so hard for, even for such a time as this. I want to see it to come to pass for your life. I feel, amen, glory to God, the moaning and groaning in the earth, hallelujah, from the people who just been laboring and just been toiling, and you're going, amen, and you're fighting to survive, and you're fighting to live, and even for those, amen, who feel like, amen, glory to God, you're on the ventilator. Amen, glory to God, and just don't know if you can just continue to put your hand to the plow. You don't know if you can just continue to work, to continue to toil. Amen, but I'm telling you, the fact that you are in a place, amen, glory to God, what I consider to be contractions in your life, just because you are in that place where you are feeling those things back to back, glory to God, that you're closer than ever before to seeing the manifestation of the word of God in your life. Your breakthrough is around the corner. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. That next step is going to be the one that, amen, glory to God, that begin to cause, amen, the flood to begin to come. That next door that you open in is going to be that connecting point that is needed that bring forth the resources, amen, to bring forth that baby to life, to live full extension. My God, in the name of Jesus, glory to God, I'm telling you, people of God, your labor has not been in pain. I know some people been in a place that God been saying, God, I want to give up right here. I just want to give in. I don't want to do this no more. I'm tired of this. I'm tired of the rejection. I'm tired of the letdown. I'm tired of every time it seemed like I'm winning, something happening, and it caused me to fall on my face, and it caused me to stumble. It caused me to fall off course. I just don't want to do this again. But I'm telling you, people of God, I'm here to encourage you tonight. Amen. And I'm here to declare and decree that your labor shall not be in vain. I'm here on tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. On assignment. Amen. Glory to God. As a child of the Most High God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. To break some things off of your life. To cancel the curse of the witch and the warlock. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm here on tonight. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. To speak with thus says the Lord. So that revival, amen, can come forth. Amen. Glory to Shia in your life. I'm here with word of encouragement, word of empowerment, a word of sustainment to strengthen you in what it is that you are getting ready to release in the earth, that's getting ready to birth on your behalf. My God, in the majestic name of Jesus, hallelujah, he has brought you too far to leave you. You have come too far to give up. You have come too far to quit, people of God. Amen. In the name of Jesus, glory, glory, glory to God. I'm excited. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. So I want us to start here in the text, people of God, because I got to get in the word on tonight. I want this to be our foundational scripture. I am going back over to 1 Samuel. We're also going to deal with some other areas in the text as well. Amen. Glory to God. So this is what the word of the Lord says in 1 Corinthians 15 and 58. People of God, those that are in labor, if you're in labor, glory to God, you need, amen, you need this particular scripture right here to be, amen, what it is that you stand on, that in which you live by, so that you can have what you need to persevere, so that you can have what it is, so that you can have the strength that you need to push that baby on out. Amen. To press towards your higher mark. So 1 Corinthians 15 and 58, it says this. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. I love it. First, I want to start here in the text. I want to start at the end, and then I'm going to back us up, because it's some vital, important information that's in this particular text right here, especially when it concerns your labor. Amen. Glory to God. First of all, it did say that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. In the Lord. If you're laboring in the Lord, then guess what? Your work is not in vain. And so it gave you three different things, right? It gave you three different things to do. So that your labor would not be in vain. It first said, be steadfast. Amen. In this walk and in this way, people of God, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, we got to become steadfast in the Lord. We got to become and come in a place, amen, where the word tells us, it said, you know, it tells us to stand firm. We got to stand firm. But let me back up for a second, because even now as I'm thinking about being in a place of being steadfast and being in a place of standing firm in the word of the Lord, amen, glory to God. So you got to be steadfast, standing firm in the word of the Lord. First, you got to get planted in God's word, amen. You got to saturate yourself in the word that God has spoken in your life, right? And so you got to, you know, amen, you got to let that word penetrate in your heart, and that word got to become the very essence of your being. And as that word become the very essence of your being, and my God, you plant yourself in the word of truth. In the word of truth. And as you plant in the word of truth, then the root of truth begin to grow. It begins to grow, the root, amen. And why the root is important? The root is important because it's the root that's going to cause you to stand firm. And so as you digest this word of truth in your life, the word that God has established for you, and as you become one with it, as you believe in it, as you, amen, glory to God, as you live your life by it, it's going to cause you to come to a place, steadfast, being committed. Commit yourself to truth. Commit yourself to the truth of God's word, because see what happens when you commit yourself to truth, when you commit yourself to the truth of God's word, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, when the devil comes with the lies and the deception, when the devil comes around warring, when the trials and the tribulations begin to come about, people of God, oh my God, in the name of Jesus, you won't be moved. You won't be moved. Why? Because you'll understand that what's taking place, what's going on in your environment, what it is that you're seeing is only a lie. You will know that it is a deceptive. Why? Because the word of God, the word of God says, look, the word of God is the lamp upon your feet and light upon your path. So what happens is when the storm comes, when the chaos comes, when the confusion comes, what begins to take place is this, people of God. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. The light, the word of God begins to illuminate from your heart, and it illuminates from your mind. It illuminates from the very innermost being part of you, and it begins to shine on that situation and on that circumstance, and it begins, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, to show you the way, to show you the path. It begins to clear the smoke, the dust. It begins to remove the deception. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, on out of your way, glory to God, oh my God, and you can tell the enemy, hey, Satan, devil, get behind me, because this be not the truth. It calls you not to be moved by a lie. So it said, be steadfast, be dependable, be dedicated, come devoted, devote your heart to the word that God has spoken for your life. And so what does devotion look like? Even in the midst of the persecution, even in the midst of the storm, I'm still dedicated. I'm still putting my hand to the work. Amen, glory to God. I'm here just envisioning Christ Jesus. My God, Christ Jesus, even from the Garden of Gethsemane, even going all the way from there, amen, going to trial, oh my God, and even getting to the point of being at the cross, I'm just envisioning him, amen, his dedication to his purpose. I'm envisioning him, and I'm imagining every step of the way when he was lied on, when he was mocked, when he was persecuted. my God, hallelujah, oh my God, you know, even when he was pierced in the side, when he was nailed to the cross, oh my God, how they spit on him and all the things that they did to him, you know, amen, put a crown on him of thorns, and you know, all the pain and the suffering that he had to go through to complete the purpose, amen, glory to God, to come to that place, amen, on the cross and say, it is finished, hallelujah, my work here is done, glory to God, I've done this work. Amen. To save the souls of mankind. My God. In the day. I'm just imagining that. I'm even thinking about, you know, a Stephen and thinking about, you know, Peter and thinking about Paul and, you know, and thinking about all these great men and women of God, even in the gospel of truth and the word of God who labored in the word for the light. And they went through so much, but even in the midst of it all, I love it. Paul and Silas in the mid in prison, and they're praising, and they're worshiping, and they're giving God honor. Oh, they're being steadfast, unmovable. They're being steadfast. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Oh, my God. Stephen in the midst of his persecutors, in the midst of persecution. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And still confess to Christ, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, even unto death, speaking and declaring what thus says the Lord. Oh, he was steadfast in truth. Oh, my God, he wouldn't bow down. He was devoted. He said, I'm so devoted to this thing. Amen. I'm devoted to death. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Paul, he said, look, I'm a bondservant. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. We got to become bondservants. We got to come be so devoted to the word of God, the will of God, the purpose of God in our lives unto death. Hey, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And so we got to stop, people of God. Amen. We get into these places in our lives, in these spaces in our lives, people of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Where trial comes and where tribulations come and we back up off the things of God. Because what begins to happen, the enemy used those things as distractions. See, Peter was able to walk on water until he got distracted. The wind blowed, and he saw it, and he got distracted. I don't even know how he's seeing wind, but he's seeing it, and he got distracted. So what wind that's coming and blowing in your life that's causing you to be distracted, and you don't stop putting your hands on the things in which God has called forth for you to do? What wind that came and blows that, amen, glory to God, just to let you know, amen, glory to God, that it's the birthing is near. Hallelujah. Thank you, Moshiach. But my God, it came to let you know that the birthing is near, that it's almost time to have this baby, that you're about to get ready to go and labor, but you get so distracted in the pain that you forget about the baby. Oh, somebody, hey, my God, somebody should have got that. You got so distracted with the pain that you forgot about that there was a baby, amen, ready to give birth in your belly, ready to come out and manifest. And so you got so caught up in the pain, you got distracted in the pain that you forgot about the baby that you needed to nurture. You forgot about the baby that was depending on you. You forgot about it, amen, glory to God, that it was depending on you and it needed you, amen, to come forth in the earth. Oh, God, thank you, Jesus. Oh, my God. That's why we got to get this word of God in. And we got to become steadfast. Become steadfast in this word, devoted, faithful. And I don't care about the trials. I don't care about the tribulation that shows up. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. It show up. I'm still showing up in truth. I'm still showing up doing the word of God. I'm still showing up doing the will of God. I'm still showing up doing what it is that God has called forth for me to do. I'm going to show up every day on time, in place, to do what it is that I've been called to do, what it is that I've been purposed to do what it is that I have committed unto God to do. I'm devoted in this thing. I'm sold out in this thing. I'm committed into this thing. I don't care what's coming my way. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, glory to God, because there's enough power in me to withstand this storm, because I'm more than a conqueror in Christ Jesus. And so when we come to that place of commitment, devoted, being steadfast, glory to God. It positioned, amen, glory to God, that word, amen, us to become rooted in the word, rooted in the word, amen, because we got to become rooted in Christ Jesus, right? And so when we are rooted in Christ Jesus, because we're devoted to truth, we're devoted, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, He's the Lord of our lives, and because of this devotion to and commitment to complete the thing in which He sent us forth to do, glory to God, through the commitment, it caused us to get rooted, and once you become rooted, when something becomes rooted, it's difficult for you to kill it. Unless you take it up by its roots. You got to move all the roots. Hey, God. Yay. You got to move all the roots, right? You got to become uprooted completely. You can cut it. You can cut off the branches. You can cut it to a stump, but it's still going to grow back up, my God, in the name of Jesus. Why? Because it's rooted down on the inside of you. And the other thing about it, man, when something is rooted in a thing, it's unmovable. It's not able to be moved. When something is, amen, rooted, amen, it becomes locked in. It becomes fixed. It's in a fixed place. Oh, glory to God. It don't waver. It don't go. You can't toss it back to and fro. It's not split between two decisions or two opinions. Amen. It's standing on one, and it is standing on what it's rooted in, what it's grounded in, what it believes in, what it has faith in, and it don't matter what comes its way. It cannot be moved. It cannot be persuaded any other way. Ooh, help us see. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's secure in that thing. And so, people, we got to be secure in this thing. We got to be secure in this walk. We got to be secure in this word. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So when things come up against the very word that God has spoken for our life, we're unmovable. I'm not going to be moved. I refuse to be moved. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. No matter what. Amen. No matter what that is taking place, dynamic people of God, we come in a place where we are not moved. My God. Then it says, look, always abiding. Always abounding in the work of the Lord, right? And so what that means, I'm always doing, right? Abounding me, I'm working in. So that vineyard, you got to be always in a place where you're working in, you know, that vineyard. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I was looking up this word. I want to just talk about some unique things that deal with this word right here. Amen. So this word right here means existing in, amen, so abounding in, always existing in the work of the Lord, or it means providing a great, okay, always providing a great work of the Lord, amen, or it means plentiful quality. I love that. Always bringing forth plenty, quality, amen, quality of work in the Lord. Or it says, or supply, amen, working, tilling that vineyard. So it says, always abiding in the work of truth. I'm sorry. Always abiding in the work of the Lord, which is the work of truth. Amen. Always abiding in the work of the Lord. And so we got to find ourselves in a place. I don't care. It said always. It didn't say sometimes. It didn't say when I feel like it or when I want to. And, you know, sometimes when we get in these places, we get in these funks and we get in these molds, and you know, I don't feel like doing this today, and you know, and just what if God just like, you know what, I don't feel like breathing on them today. Oh Jesus, oh no, just what if he said that? Lord, thank you, Lord, I thank you that you always abiding in, oh my God, that you always abiding in the word, God, I thank you, you're faithful to that, hallelujah, thank you Jesus. But back on us, they say always. It didn't say sometimes abiding in it. And amen, glory to God. And I like it. It said always existing in. That means I'm always, I love that, existing in the work of the Lord. Staying in that place where your hand is in the work, into the toil. We shouldn't have, amen, times in our lives where we're not abiding in the work, where we're not existing in this work, that this powerful work, this dynamic work that God has called forth in our lives, what he's called for us to do, people of God. I'm telling you, because guess what? One of the things, amen, glory to God, that I think about, that I think about, people of God, is this. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Because I think in Revelations he tells them, I know your labor. Or he said, I know your work. I know your work, your labor is, you know. Oh, I know your work. And so what is it going to be said about our work? Is it something that he's going to commend us on? Or something that he would judge us? And so we have to think about that. And so when he say, I know your works, would it be saying, look, I see you work diligently in the vineyard. I seen you labor and your labor not in vain, oh good and faithful servant. Come in. And when he say, oh, I know your works, and you are a work of iniquity, I never knew you. And so, people of God, we got to, amen, glory to God, make sure that we are always existing in or abiding in this work. Amen, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Because it's very, very vital. It's very, 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 very important. I'm gonna amen, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Because when we are steadfast, unmovable, always abiding, and laboring in the work of the Lord, we will be rewarded. We're going to be rewarded. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. The word, amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. This word labor. I want to also give you this other definition, amen, that I got here. It's this: to labor, to toil, to suffer hardship. The word means never cease, never stop, never slack. Never be a slacker, never quit, never retire, toiling and working to the point of exhaustion or fatigue, to the point of collapse. The believer's labor will never be in vain. Left empty, it will never be left empty or unrewarded. As long as we labor, our laboring is in the Lord. And I know when I come back, I'm going to quickly hit, quite a bit of things, amen, when it comes to this thing, labor. And I'm praying that I get back over to First Samuel, because I really, really want to get over to there as well. But we got to take a quick break right here in the church, amen, in the majestic name of Jesus. And so we're going to be right back in the church. Go ahead and share this broadcast on your social media platform so that those that you know can get in this powerful conversation. Share it in your groups. Amen. You can go ahead and text it to somebody. Look, y'all got to get to inthechurch.com on tonight. Amen. Glory to God in this last hour. Amen. That we have here, diligently laboring in this word. of truth. And I want to talk about it, people of God. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Also know that surely you can dial in. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You can dial in at 563-999-1824. Again, you can dial in at 563-999-1824. Also, amen, on our social media platforms, you can definitely also go to In the Church Live on Twitter, and you can get us right there. Amen. You can get the show there, and you can also comment on it there. Put your comment, your prayer request, as well as your questions. You can place it right there on Twitter, and we will reply to you, or you can DM us directly on there. You can do it on In the Church on our Facebook page. You can do it right there as well, and we'll respond to you, or if you're on the Spreaker platform, or if you're on our website at inthechurch.com. You can communicate there, but we would love to hear your voice in the studio. Amen. On tonight, would love to hear your voice in the studio if you can, if you're in a position or place that you can call in at 563-999-1824 with your questions, your comments, or your prayer requests, or to just get in on this powerful conversation. Once you log into the studio, just hit *6 and it will bring you in our, it'll pull you up and pull you in the queue, and I will go ahead, amen, and bring you live, amen, in the In the Church TV and radio broadcast, my God, in the majestic name of Jesus. Glory, glory, glory be unto God. We'll be right back in the church.
Place of worship. to pray. My heart wants to pray, but my soul wants to play.
Hallelujah, glory. Glory be unto God in this place. If you don't know by now, oh my God, that he's a healer. Amen. That he's your hope, that he gives you strength, that he gives you everything that you need. If you don't know him, it's time to know him. And he's none other than Jesus Christ. Amen. Himself in the majestic name of Jesus. Oh my God, just absolutely love who he is. Oh my God, my healer, my protector, my strength, my peace, my joy, my God, in the name of Jesus. We do want to welcome you back to the In the Church TV and radio broadcast, where we are shining the light, amen, of God's word in the church on the good, the bad, and the ugly. Yes, you are listening to nominated best show, best TV show, and best radio show, nominated for the Image, Gospel Image Awards, and the Spin Awards. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory, glory, glory be unto God. And so we bless God and we thank God in this place, amen, for just being nominated, amen, for both of these prestigious awards. And you are listening, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, amen, to a dynamic program, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah, that is loved by so many and that is helping so many people, amen, around the world, throughout the nations, amen, in the majestic name of Jesus. We are talking about an absolutely amazing topic. Before I jump into that, let me stop and pause for a moment. And welcome, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. Brazil, thank you for joining us in the church on tonight. I see you out there. Amen. You guys over there in Nairobi, thank you for joining us. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. I see you over there in France and Ireland. Thank you for joining us in the church on tonight. It is such a privilege to have you with us. Glory to God. Australia in the church. Amen. Hallelujah. We know that the U.S. is surely in the church on tonight. Amen. And we thank God. We thank God. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. And so we bless God for each and every last one of you in your respective country. You know, Asia, Europe, bless you. Africa, amen, our family, our friends down there in Nigeria, we definitely not forget about you, those that's in North America, South America, bless you, amen, even Antarctica, amen, we just bless God, the seven continents of the world that, amen, that we are touching lives, affecting lives, impacting lives, and so we thank you for joining us in the church on tonight, amen. I am your host, Apostle Derashay Zorn, and it is a privilege to be with you on tonight. You, and you. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And I want to thank everybody that makes this show possible. Make this show possible. Family, friends, amen. I just thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Supporters, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It is such a privilege and an honor to be in the midst of such people that love us to life, that love us to life. So I thank you for it. Amen. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. So, but I want us to get in this text. We're talking about your labor not being in vain. We're talking about your labor not being in vain. Woo! Glory to God. Let's talk about this. I'm going to get over to Isaiah, amen, and I'm going to about this as well. We just read or finished 1 Corinthians 15 and 58. Let me pull up Isaiah over here, Isaiah, and I'm going to talk about it briefly, amen, and because I do want to get back over to 1 Samuel chapter 4, amen. Glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. Look, I'm going over to 1 Samuel now. I'm so anxious to get over there, right? You're going to Isaiah right now, Isaiah 65. Okay, so we're going to look at Isaiah 65. Isaiah 65 really quickly, if I would get over here to the right chapter. Right. Hey, amen, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And so we're over here on Isaiah 55, and I just want to go in some of God's encouragement, right, unto the people of Israel, to his chosen people, and also God's word of encouragement unto us. God's word of encouragement unto us this afternoon. And I want to start here at verse 17. It says, "For behold, I create new heavens and a new earth, and the former shall be remembered, shall not be remembered or come to mind, but be glad and rejoice forever in what I create. For behold, I create Jerusalem as a rejoicing and her people a joy. I will rejoice in Jerusalem and joy in my people. The voice of weeping shall no longer be heard in her, nor the voice of crying." Amen. Glory to God. Because I understand, as you've been toiling, people of God, as you've been working, amen, glory to God, and you've been passionate and you've been doing the work and you've been putting your hand to what it is that God has commissioned you to do, I know that there have been some nights where you've been weeping, and there have been some nights where you've been crying, and I love it because God said, look, amen, glory to God, see, you're about to give birth, and you ain't going to have, it ain't going to be too many more tears that's going to be released from your eyes, amen, glory to God, from because of the suffering, because of the depth of the pain and of some of the injuries and things that's taking place in your life. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. That is going forth. You're no longer going to be weeping anymore or crying anymore. Amen. Just give it a little bit longer. Amen. Hallelujah. It's almost over. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. It's at that point, almost at that point. Amen. Glory to God, where the water is breaking and the baby is on his way out. And we understand that the contractions, the trials, the tribulations and all of that, they can be a little painful, and it caused you to cry. It caused you to come in a place of anguish. It caused you to cry out, my God. It caused you to weep because of the pain, the depth of the pain and all of those other things. But God is saying, amen, glory to God, don't give up. Hallelujah. Don't stop in the middle of it. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Because it's going to be a day. Amen. It's going to stop. It's going to be no longer, you no longer have to weep. You're no longer going to be crying about it, because you're going to now be able to live into the manifestation of, you're going to be able to eat the fruit of your labor. Amen. I'm excited about that. I'm always excited. And then it says here in verse 20, and I really should save it to after I get out of 1 Samuel, but it says, "No more shall an infant from there live but a few days, nor a old man who has not fulfilled his days. For the child shall die 100 years old, but the sinner being 100 years old shall be accursed." And my God, I just love it. Amen. It said, "No more shall an infant from there live but a few days." Amen. Hallelujah. See, some people, amen, see, there have been some things, amen, in your life that, amen, you have vision, you have goals and aspiration. There have been some things that you gave birth to, and the longevity of it was very short. This is what God is saying here. Amen. But you're getting ready to birth here. Ha. What was getting ready to be released, what you're getting ready to taste and see and touch, the manifestation from the toiling and labor. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. It ain't gonna live a short life. It's gonna have longevity in it. Ah. Somebody got to hear that, amen, in the name of Jesus. See, somebody been a little discouraged because, amen, you've been through those birthings, and you've been in those places and things where that in which you birthed and that in which you gave birth to, it was short-lived. Something came and took the very life, and amen, out of your baby, out of that, out of the what you have worked and you had taught for, and something came and stole the very life of it. The enemy came and killed, steal, and destroyed it. Many a time and assignment, nothing again. But God has said, this one, this is, hey, God, thank you, Jesus. This one right here, amen, glory to God. If you just hang in in the midst of the contractions and in the midst of the hurt and in the midst of the pain and all those other things, you just hold on right there, son, right there, daughter. You hold on, I'm going to show you. Don't give up. Hallelujah, glory to God. My God, let the joy of the Lord be your strength in this thing, through the pain and through the hurt and through the disappointments and through the letdowns. Let the joy of the Lord be your strength, my God, so that you can give birth to this baby, so that you won't die in childbirth, in labor, and so that neither the baby will die in labor. Amen. We're declaring, decreeing today that your baby shall not die in labor and you shall not die in labor. And we're declaring, decreeing what thus says the Lord as well, that this one that you birth out is going to have a longevity. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We're going to declare and decree that it's going to outlive you. That your descendants. Hallelujah. That your descendants, amen, glory to God, going to pick up this thing right here. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Long after you're gone, and it's still going to be thriving, and it's still going to be moving, and it's still going to be active in the earth, doing the very thing in which God has called forth for it to do. Hey, Lord, hey. It said, look. They shall build houses and inhabit them. They shall plant vineyards and eat their fruit. They shall not build and another inhabit it. They shall not plant and another eat it. Oh, saith the Lord. But as the days of a tree, so shall the days of my people and my elect shall long enjoy the work of their hands. Ah, somebody, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My God, y'all know I'm getting excited over here, amen, in this word of truth, just declaring what thus saith the Lord. Somebody ought to got it excited right then and right there, because, see, you've been in places and things where you've been building, and somebody else don't came and stole it, and somebody else don't came and took it, amen. God, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You don't build things and somebody else don't inhabit it. The devil is a lie. God said, look, amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. He said, this one you build in, amen, you're going to inhabit it. You're going to dwell in it. Amen. This right here, what you're planting right here in the earth, you're going to eat the fruit of the labor, love it. Some ain't nobody else going to continue to eat the fruit, of your labor. Ain't nobody else going to continue to eat the fruit of it, getting fat, getting prosperous of that in which you have been laboring, that in which you have been toiling in. My God, in the name of Jesus, keep your hands to the work that God has called for you to do. Too many people have ate off the fruit of your labor, and you ain't been able to eat none of it. You ain't been able to prosper from it. You just been able to barely get by off your own labor. But I'm declaring and decreeing in this place on tonight that it shall be no more, in the majestic name of Jesus. My God, you shall eat the fruit of your labor. You shall prosper from it, in the majestic name of Jesus. Oh my God, you shall live fat off it. My God, you shall enjoy it in its fullness, in the name of Jesus. You are no longer pig of the Moshiach. You are no longer being places of limitations. You are no longer being places, my God, in the name of Jesus. You will no longer be in the places where, my God, hallelujah, glory to God, the locusts, the cankerworm, they ain't coming eating your stuff no more. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, and glory to God. You're going to eat the fruit of your own labor. Yes, yes, Lord, in the name of Jesus, glory to God. And so let me get down here to what I've been trying to get to, which was verse 23, right? And verse 23 says this. Ooh, he said, they shall not labor in vain, nor bring forth children for trouble. For thy shall be the descendants of the blessed of the Lord, and their offspring with them. It shall come to pass that before they call, I answer. And while they are still speaking, I will hear. Oh, somebody ought to bless the name of Jesus. Somebody ought to bless the name of Jesus. Because the word says that, look, your labor, it ain't going to be in vain. And you know, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. And what you bringing forth, amen, glory to God, the blessing of the Lord, make it rich and add no sorrow. Glory to God, thank you, Jesus. That baby that you're getting ready to give birth to, that goal, that dream, that vision that's getting ready to just manifest right before your very eyes, it's not going to be a troubled child. Ah, bless your name. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. It's not going to be a troubled child. Amen, glory to God. That child, that one right there, you should be excited because of that one right there. It ain't going to be a troubled child. It's going to do what it's supposed to do. It's going to, amen, it's going to grow up the way it's supposed to grow up. Amen. It ain't going to cause you no headache, and it ain't going to cause you no pain. And my God, and Lord have mercy. My God, now God have mercy. We thank you in the name of Jesus. That baby, amen, it just going to grow and mature, and it's going to be a peace, and it's going to do everything that has been called forth to do. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. My God. I love it. I love it. I love it. This baby that you're bringing forth. It's going to, amen, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. This baby that you're bringing forth, know that this child, this goal, dream, vision, aspiration, amen, it is surely a blessed, prosperous work from the Lord. And that, amen, glory to God, that it shall bless you and it shall bless your descendants. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let me go real quickly to these particular texts. I probably won't make it over to 1 Samuel today, but that's okay. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God, because I'm excited right where I am in the text on tonight. But I want to talk about, you know, even this laboring. Amen. Glory to God. You know, Psalms 127 says this. Right, because we want to make sure that even what we're laboring for, what we're in labor for, that it is the Lord. He said, look, unless the Lord builds it, unless the Lord builds the house, the labor in vain, they labor in vain who build it. Unless the Lord guards the city, the watchman stays awake in vain. And so, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. What you're laboring for, amen, glory to God, it got to be that which is of the Lord, that in which God has spoken in your life, that in which God has told for you to do. See, Proverbs 23 and 4, it tells us something like this. It said, do not overwork yourself to be rich and become, because of your own understanding, don't do those things. It said, don't overwork. Do not overwork to be rich because of your own understanding. It said, cease from doing that. Over in the book of John, Jesus says this, John chapter 6, 26, he says this. He said, most surely I say to you, you seek me not because you saw the signs, but because you ate of the loaves and was filled. Here we go, verse 27. Do not labor for the food which perishes, but for the food which endures to everlasting life, which the Son of Man will give you, because God the Father has set his seal. Oh, bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So even in our laboring, we got to be laboring for the kingdom of God. We can't be laboring, amen, for recognition and power and position, for fortune and fame, for comfort or for pleasure and all those other things, for selfish reason and selfish motives and all those things alike. For surely the earth will full of things that can surely provide pleasure unto man, but it does not satisfy. It leaves the very soul and the essence of man empty, incomplete, unfulfilled, hunger, dissatisfied. Amen. Word of God, it keeps you in a place of void. It keeps you in a place of brokenness. It keeps you in a place of hurt, pain, confusion, as it consumes your very life. But it said, look, heaven and earth will pass away, but the word of the Lord, amen. The word of the Lord, amen, word of God. The word of the Lord will never pass away. It will be here. And so it has to be the word of the Lord, in the word of the Lord in which we labor. And so we have to labor in that which endures. And that which endures is the word of God. That which is going to outlast everything else is God's word. In God's word alone, nothing else has the sustainment of life in that capacity but God's word. And so I can't get caught up in all of my emotions and all these other things that, amen, word of God, thank you, Jesus, that will leave me with an empty life, that will leave me in a place of confusion and stuck and broken and all these other things. Amen, word of God, thank you, Jesus. I got to labor for, amen, that which does not perish, that which, amen, endures forever. And that's the word of the Lord. It said, but for the food, it said, do not labor for food which perishes, but for the food which endures to everlasting life. Oh, somebody, I better hear the spirit of the true living God here on tonight. Because Jesus Christ, he is, hallelujah. He is the bread from heaven. He is, amen, the manna, fresh manna, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. He said, I am the bread of life. And he said, he who comes to me shall never be hungry. And he who believes in me, my God, shall never thirst again. And so, people of God, we got to, amen, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, labor for that which is everlasting. Not that which is temporary, because we're not going to get anywhere, amen. It won't sustain us. That's why we got to get this word in us, because it gives us sustainment. So while that we are going through these contractions, while we're having trials, tribulations, the storm comes, it gives us the strength that we need to endure. So we can push past the storm, push past the pain, push past the problem, push past the hurt. Amen. Glory to God. We have to push. Look, pray until something happen. Prophesy until something happen. Preach until something happen. My God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. My God. Persevere until something happen. And glory to God, that water breaking, that baby is here. Mighty people of God, my God, in the name of Jesus. Well, in the name of Jesus. The word says this in Psalm 128. It said, blessed is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in his ways. When you eat the labor of your hands, you'll be happy. And it shall be well with you. Again, They're still talking about it. Amen. You're going to eat the fruit of your labor. That's why you got to labor in the word. Labor in the word. Labor in the word, because it brings forth. It brings forth good fruit. It brings forth the fruit, people of God, that brings forth sustainment of life. The word also tells us that every man will be rewarded according to his own labor. And so we ain't got time to be lazy. We ain't got time to get, amen, to get sedated in labor. That's what we got to have natural birth. We got to have natural birth. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. And we got to get this word. My God, not, oh, give this word on the inside of us so that we can walk in the dunamis power of God and overcome every adversary, every foe, amen, in the name of Jesus. I am opening up the lines, amen, people of God. You can, I am going to, you know, just continue to minister out this word of truth, but you can hit *6. If you're, have you dialed in the studio, you can hit *6, amen, glory to God, and it'll bring you up in the queue, and we'll bring you live in the church, amen. You have any questions, comments, or prayer requests, you can dial in at 563-999-1824. Let me say that again, 563-999-1824. Come on in the church with us on tonight, amen. We'll answer your questions, your prayer requests, and any comments that you may have. If you're on the Spreaker platform, if you're on In the Church, if you're on Twitter at In the Church Live, or Facebook at the In the Church Facebook page, you can leave your prayer requests, your comments, or questions there. Amen. We'll deal with them on the air. Or if you want to DM me, direct message me, or inbox me privately, you can send it there as well. Amen. At the In the Church platform, or through the email from our In the Church page. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. We'll definitely respond to you appropriately. Amen. Because we definitely want to see the word of God and the will of God happening in the lives of his people. Amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. Oh, God. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let me call Pastor. Amen. But we just bless the name of, amen, the true living God. Amen. In the church. Amen. On tonight, as we are surely not laboring in vain. Amen. We gonna have these babies. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. And we're going to have some successful deliveries. Amen. Glory to God. The enemy can't stop us from delivering these babies. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory be unto God. In the church on tonight, amen. In the majestic name of Jesus. So let's I want to say this, amen, and glory to God, and I may come back and do something just on this text here later, amen. Hallelujah. The Proverbs 14, it says this: in all labor there is profit. Somebody catch that. In all labor there is profit. Know that, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah, that your laboring is prosperous. There is, amen, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. God doesn't call us to labor and not a man be able to reap the harvest from the labor. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And so that's why, amen, glory to God, it's important, people of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. That we labor. I just believe some of the things that we've been praying for, some of the things that we've been asking about, some of the things that we desire, people of God, we don't have it. Why? Because it's in our laboring in the word of the Lord, amen, for our lives, that we will come into a place of the manifestation of the things in which we're asking for. In the things in which we're asking for. And so if we can come into a place of alignment, if we can come into a place of alignment with this word of truth, if we come into a place of alignment with this word of truth, amen, glory to God, some of the things that we're seeking is going to be found right there. It's in the laboring. It's in the laboring. He said, I've already made the provision. I just need you, amen, to go ahead and birth it out and receive. I need you to go ahead and birth it out and receive. Go ahead and birth out what it is and receive what it is that I've declared for you. Because surely, amen, surely, surely, surely is there. And so people of God, we have to come into places and spaces in our lives that, amen, glory to God, we keep our hands to the plow and don't look back. Don't stop, but keep pushing forward. Keep pushing forward. Reaching for what's ahead so that you can obtain what it is that God has put before your eyes. That very promise. So that it can manifest for you. Because people of God, as surely as you put in the work, God is going to ensure that the manifestation. So our role, and I'm going to close with this here, our role into seeing this harvest of our labor, reaping the harvest of our labor, is to just do what God told us to do. Put our hands to what God has told us to do. And God is gonna deal with the results. We ain't gotta worry about the results. That ain't our issue. That's not on us. That's what God does.
When I'm deaf.
And so we just trust and we be faithful and we just believe in what He said. And we just be obedient.
I don't sure just help her.
Or how about just